I've been getting a lot of questions about how I got started, so I thought I'd put together this short video for you. I've been a big MMA fan for over 6 years now, and I've met lots of fighters over the years. About a year and a half ago, I came up with an idea for an MMA show called MMA The Hard Way. The original concept for the show was for me to visit all the MMA gyms in Orange County and slowly learn MMA from the different instructors. In October 2010, I was invited to do some red carpet interviews at the UFC Magazine and Silver Star pre-fight party for UFC 121. That was an awesome night. I got to interview lots of fighters and MMA celebrities like Mike Goldberg and Mark Dellagrotte. I introduced myself to Bruce Buffer for the first time. That was so cool. There were tons of fighters there that night, and I made some great connections. I even got to meet Sean Tompkins that night. I attended the Fighters Only MMA Awards in December 2010. It was the second year that they had put on the event, and I got to meet lots of people there as well. I was also invited by James Hurgot to attend the red carpet premiere of The Striking Truth, a documentary on Georges St-Pierre and David Loazo. It was an honor to be in the audience that night. I was sitting right behind Mike Goldberg and Bruce Buffer. Later, I was able to visit Nam Pham at his gym in Garden Grove, Madhu Academy.
This is Nam
And in
Pham,
early
the one who
January
made
of
the hard way.
2011, I got to interview him. He had just begun his UFC career after being on The Ultimate Fighter the previous fall. It was great to get to know him better. He's a fantastic person. By February 2011, I was
What's
able
up,
to
guys?
debut
This is
my
Mark
first
Munoz,
episode
and
of
you're watching
MMA The Hard
MMA The
Way.
Hard Way.
This featured Rain Training Center in Lake Forest, California. Mark Munoz allowed me and my crew to film there over the course of 2 days. We were lucky to catch it when members of both King's MMA and Alliance Training Center were visiting. There were tons of well-known fighters there that day, and a bunch of them that were just getting started. I then reached out to Jason Stewart, the president of Epic Fighting in San Diego. He had started a new amateur fighting promotion about a year prior to that, and I was anxious to see what it was like to put on a local MMA show. He was totally game for the idea and allowed me full access to film the fighters before, during, and after their fights. What followed was one of my favorite episodes. The second episode, I called it First Fight. I got a real glimpse into what the guys go through. In fact, Epic Fighting 4 struck me so profoundly, I decided to dedicate the rest of 2011 to following those amateur MMA fighters. And I focused on several up-and-coming fighters that I had met there at Epic. And I was able to create several fighter focus videos to help them promote their upcoming fights.
The mother of your baby child, the one to whom.
By the beginning of 2012, I began to reach out to some of my local fighting heroes like Mike Joker Guyman and James Lightning Wilkes. I also filmed a feature on Spirit Wolf and his leader of the pack, Paul Blankenflor.
But you are not alone in this.
During this whole time, I continued to make new friends with many fighters, and through Mike Guyman, I met Andy Morales. Andy's been fighting locally for a few years, and he told me about some of his background. I told him about my time at Team Oyama, and He mentioned that he had graduated from Dana Hills High School with Ian McCall, Shane Del Rosario, Rob Emerson, and Bao Quach. We talked about what a cool story that would be to tell. And so that is what I've been working on. It's funny, you know, Coach Colin Oyama was the first coach to ever let me bring my camera into an MMA gym. He is an incredible instructor. And it's funny, I got started there, and through the course of a year and a half, I learned how to be a filmmaker. I learned how to tell a story. I learned how to be better technically. I also built relationships with fighters and people in the fight game. And all of this led up to me working on my most ambitious project, and that is to film a documentary of my own. I'm calling it Class of One, and it's about those five guys that graduated from Dana Hills High together, and now they're all five pro fighters. So I look forward to working on this, and sometime, hopefully, before the end of summer, the film will come out. There'll be very few episodes of MMA The Hard Way. However, I do think I'm going to have some of the local fighters go down and we'll run through some of the local fight cards and get their picks on some of the UFC events. So thank you for watching. Thank you for being a fan. And I hope you look forward to watching Class of One.